All right, welcome back to Computer Vision. We're going to continue introducing particle filters for tracking. I also want to say thank you. I think it's Sebastian Thrun and or Dieter Fox or somebody else who's done a bunch of slides that have actually lost their authorship is lost to all of humanity, because if you take a look at particle filtering, you'll see these same pictures everywhere. So whoever did them, thanks. All right. So you remember, I hope, that the reason we're doing all this is because, unlike Kalman filter, where we were going to represent the densities to where things are with a nice Gaussian, the idea is we might want to have an arbitrary density. And graphically, that's what's shown here, the idea of propagating a density through time. Now, the basic idea that we're going to make use of is, instead of having some sort of analytic representation of our densities, we're going to have these set of particles. We talked before about how the distribution in terms of where the particles are and perhaps the weight of the particles, that's what we're going to substitute for the density, right? And our goal is so that as we're doing this tracking, eventually we have a set of particles such that the probability that you get a particle at some particular place is essentially the probability that the state is actually at that place, having observed all the observations. And the way we do this is we're going to do this as a Bayes filter. We introduced this last time, where we said that basically you take your prediction from before, and the way you get to your prediction is you take your previous belief of all the different places you might be and talk about the probability that you could end up at some given xt. You sum that all up, and that's your prior belief that you could be at xt. You take your measurement, you multiply it by your likelihood, and because of Bayes' rule, which does the swapping of the variables, that gives us our new belief about xt. So we're going to take particles, and we're going to define a Bayes filter using those particles.